Guys, so this is an update to our original Gensyn video. As some of you may know, Gensyn released an update and we've incorporated those changes into our marketplace so that you're actually able to run with those additional parameters. So in this video, we're going to quickly cover how to launch Gensyn using a wide variety of hardware. The latest updates to Gensyn enables you to run the models on lower end GPUs as well as higher end GPUs. So obviously, depending on which GPU you choose, you'll obviously be setting the specific model for that GPU. So let's dive in and look at how we can launch Gensyn using the latest parameters on lower end GPUs as well as higher end GPUs. So we'll start with the lower end GPU first. So obviously, the first thing you want to do is go to the OctaSpace marketplace. I'll leave a link down below if you don't know how to access that. If you haven't seen our original Gensyn video, I'll also leave a link to it in this video so you can understand how to launch it, albeit I'll cover most of those basics in this video as well. So let's dive straight in. So once you're in the marketplace, you'll want to select mining and then obviously select Gensyn. You'll be redirected to this page where you'll choose the actual nodes. I've already filtered here to at least 8 GB since that's the minimum VRAM that we can run it on. So let's choose a node that we think is suitable. I've sorted here, I think, by lowest price. Let me have a look. Yep, so we can have a look at some of these nodes. Bear in mind on the storage costs on some of those. Here's a node for 8 cents an hour. It's a 8 GB 3060 Ti. So let's go with that. Click configure. Let's go with add environmental variable. And we want to add the variable HF token. And here you'll paste your Hugging Face token. Okay, next one, we want to add the next environmental variable, which is param underscore B. And since we've chosen a lower end GPU, we'll want to type in 0.5. The next environmental variable, use underscore big underscore swarm. And here we want to type false. Since this only has 30 GB, so we'll set 30 GB, although ideally this should be 50 GB. So let's click deploy. So we'll want to wait till the status says service configured. Okay, now it says service configured. We want to click on it. We want to make sure we log into the swarm first. So we want to log into the Gensyn testnet. Okay, now we're logged into the Gensyn testnet. We're going to close this down and then go back to Access Web SSH. If you haven't run the swarm before, you're going to choose this option called the Run RL Swarm. If you have, you can upload your PEM file, which I will do now. Okay, I've uploaded my PEM file, so I'm going to choose Run RL Swarm, and it should start. Okay, so after a couple of minutes of going through the motions, downloading the accurate model, it should now start training. So as we can see, it's already joining the next round and starting at the next stage. Let's dive into how to do this for a higher end GPU. So with a higher end GPU, I'm going to select mining again, I'm going to select Gensyn. Then we're going to want to go with 24 GB of VRAM. So, okay, let's sort by cheapest first. So we can have a look at those. Okay, so there's a 3090 here we can use. Let's choose these. So these are great. So select this one, click configure. We want to add environmental variable. So Hugging Face token again. We're going to add param B, but this time, because it's a 4090, we're going to choose a bigger one. So let's go with 1.5 and then use big swarm. We're going to choose true and select deploy and then wait till service configured. Okay, service is configured. So we choose this here, we have to log in. So we'll log into the Gensyn testnet. Okay, we're logged in. And then we go back to Access Web SSH, and we just choose Run RL Swarm. And it will start obviously going through the motions, download the correct model. So in this instance, we chose 1.5. I will leave a cheat sheet below. So depending on which hardware you choose, you can choose the right configurations. As we can see, we've joined the swarm. And that's all there is to it. Pretty much straightforward. I'll leave a link down to the documentation below so you can see the specific configuration and what settings to choose. But obviously we make it very, very simple to run. So again, if you get stuck, feel free to ping us on Discord or Telegram. I'll leave a link down below to that as well. And make sure to follow us for additional videos.